Okay, in this whole series of video, we'll talk about metals, or more specifically, advanced metal. Alright, the term advanced metal. And just an introduction is that it is used for automotive applications. For example, typical area of usage includes high strength steel sheeting. Alright, so a sheet of metal has very high strength. This is what it's trying to say. Super plastic aluminium. Plastic itself means that it's elastic. So if you were to pull this aluminium, it can come back to its original shape. Alright, or elastic in the meaning. So it's more on the super plastic aluminium. Smart materials talks about so-called whether the materials has a lot of properties and things like that. And etc. Alright. And it is estimated that advanced materials in cars have increased from 7% to 40%. Okay, and why? It's because of all these things, all these properties that we have mentioned: high strength, plastic, smart material, advanced material, etc. Okay, so therefore, this is an example of a BMW's materials being used across time. So they are targeting on the light alloy body parts. Alright, so this starts from here, 1950. Okay, so previously they used aluminium for their crankcase, and a long time they actually used a aluminium magnesium crankcase, which is a alloy material. Alright, and then nonetheless they will have certain stuff like shock absorber struts, etc. Alright, talking about safety issues when driving, ceramic catalyst. Alright, because ceramic itself, I think, can take in thermal heat relatively well, or it can resistance against heat, alright, things like that. And then composite, fiber reinforced polymer, aluminium chassis, alright, because it's also light. Everything is about aluminium because it's very lightweight. Alright, so you can see there's a trend in using so-called light material, alright. And this also explain why this is very important in exams, like compare metal and composite of choice over the car. Alright, so why do we use composite and metal in car? It's because the objective in car is often fuel consumption, because you want to lower it. Alright, so it's more environmental friendly and things like that. So therefore, to cut off fuel consumption, you need to have a lighter lighter materials being used, alright, while having a good resistance against impact. So in other words, the term like high strength to weight ratio comes in, alright, so to cut down fuel. And this doesn't apply to just automotive, it also applies in aerospace. People use composite, advanced composites, which we have said in the previous sections already, but nonetheless, advanced metals can be applied over there as well. So these are the things that you may want to consider when talking about questions. So they may ask you this type of questions and you want to so-called think of it. Actually, don't know what is rear window demister, and I think this one is to clear away the mist. Normally if you were to drive, alright, like you're driving over here, then there will be a layer of mist over here. So there will be a heater over here to actually clear away the mist. I think this is what it's trying to say. So it's a rear window demister. Okay, yeah, at least I learned something. So nonetheless, this is overall, this is just a somewhat introduction into advanced metals. Alright, so in the next video, I will still talk about some introduction, because I actually came from the previous the next video. So took quite a while and think about it, and I realized that I will introduce this video first, then I will talk about the next video. So the rest of the thing will talk about all this stuff coming up. So this is just a quick introduction, and also a standard type of questions on why do we use metal on composite, and why do you choose metal against composite, or composite against metal. So you may want to talk about like against impact or whatever it is. Okay, hopefully this is pretty clear. See you next video. Goodbye.